I said in part one, gonna erase the white and gray floor first. First, I'm gonna put outsides of the track down. Let's see how I can fill it up with panels. So priority now is to do the up and down bits. Which these track blocks here, the angled ones, just because it covers a lot of ground and it's easy to fill the track up, and you get a quick view of how many props you got left. So for the straights, I'm gonna try to use the bigger panels if possible. I still want to erase here. So we'll just be starting here. Maybe this is an exception because it's a bridge here. So I might make it a wide tunnel though. It's easier to cover it up if you do it wide. I don't like the curbs showing, so I'm gonna take the opposite. So it's a track down, so we take a track up. What was it, 5? So we take this one. The ups are easy, they have a center point that's above the prop, so you can rotate it nicely. You don't have to go into manual override. I'll do this now anyway. It easy on myself. See, if you see the line pop up, it's perfectly parallel to the other prop. It's always in the same angle if you select and deselect the purple prop. Use that now. So I'm gonna hide the curbs. What I want to say was that I try to get as close to that line as possible and slightly off. Not very much. Covering the curbs. I keep it horizontal, just keep it easy. I haven't decided on the color yet. So we'll see what is best. So, probably try some combinations. Most people think color is not that important, but plays a big role in everything in our reality, actually. Because it's a play of the eyes. It's kind of the filter system that you use, which decides which color you see. Okay, so I don't need to hide, don't need to show curves, I can just cover it all. And for the other bit here, I'm gonna have to leave open the curve on the right side here. Or maybe just a little on the bottom here. So you go outside here and then you leave the curve open. And that way it's pretty good that they have that problem with such long extends. Easier shoulder for overall usage. So easy snap here if I place the black one correctly, and this one should be evenly parallel, which I see it isn't. Little adjustment and the rotation necessary. See the line goes over the white bit. I'll have to rotate it a little bit. I could leave it, but I always check a little bit. See the slide issue in the rotation. This one also needs some correction on the Z-axis. Now I'm going for the outsides here. is not the best call. So I'm gonna have to cheat a bit. Covered curbs here. Probably leave this open. Covered curbs from here on where the wall starts. So now I don't need this anymore. it's the inside, it's gonna cover up the inside hole of the track here, simulating that grass with the green. Bring it to the middle and get the best view of where the actual middle is. To level it with the straight route. So it's not parallel yet, I have to rotate it a bit. Get the overriding prop here from the other prop that's connected to the star there. I can put this a bit higher. Now what I'm gonna have to do here is angle it on the length of the panel here. I hope I can still cover up the curve like that. Less is possible. Looking for the lowest amount of angle. So now the prop is gone there. A little bit of curve showing through here. Maybe tilt. And a little bit like that. That's nicely covered. Might have to rotate it a bit in that way. No, that was too much. Should have done that. Okay, so now it's in a good angle. Now I can move it left or right as much as I want. Glide it in here, so can I cover that hole? I do want to match up the curve here. That's fine. No, that's too far. It's sticking out here. Have to do it with this. The hole is not bad. I mean, nobody's going to hit anything there. Nobody's going to disappear into the hole. I have to cover it up anyway. Okay, that looks good. Gonna simulate a bridge here, so I might keep it concrete or maybe the dark green here. So maybe it's the, no, now I need to cover the curves on the outside here when the wall starts. Now it's in the same angle as the track prop. length axle angle. So that angle. Can't forget to erase props because there's already one disappearing here. Quick save. Okay, so this corner, this part's a bit tricky here. Gonna use this prop, so I don't need anything here. Now, the gray one here, the gray part here, is a straight flat piece, so kinda use the big panels there. Get rid of those. Reset the prop. Might have to glide that under. Not sure what the angle was. I thought it wasn't exactly level. Change the color correctly. So curbs can be visible on the outside over here. Well, just put it on this piece. I'm gonna rotate it. I bring it to the gray prop now. World is slightly more precise. See if it's better. If it goes over the line, I have to go to the local. Find a bit. target position that I want. Level at this point. Either rotate it and cover half of the turret or just cover it all. Glide it more over to this side. See how far it matches up. The yellow bit is a bit of an angle, so now it dives under the yellow. Take this one. Put it. Shit. I need this shoulder card. Use that small bit, or I can use a big pedal, which is the equal prop count, equal memory. I don't lose anything. Didn't work mechanic. Magnetic. Why is this prop stuck in rotation? Okay, I'm gonna erase that. No problem. Rechargeables. Lifesavers. Change the color correctly. Pink is too bright, you can't see the contrast. Sections on the path. So, what I do now? Always going to overlap the curve here, unless I lower it. I have to. So if I lower, even lower. Fills up this area too. On the inside. Convenient. Now I can leave this curve open here. So I can cover it up with some glass. I can do that, but so we can pop. Fast enough to not cover it up anymore. Cover up the side. Just have to do that. The stacking is easy now if you want to push it right to the floor and see if you want. This is also a good match now. Maybe it will bump out. Maybe a bit more. Character. Might cover in the curve. that as an extra prop. We need to cover up this one now. Now let's move back to the big one. Yeah, leave the arrow here a little bit. So we can start over here. change that. Let's see. This is our paddock area, or the other side. Yeah. Still in the same angle with this, which is handy. We'll have to angle it a little more. What's the bit name on the left? I'm just trying to cover all the curves here. Something like this. That hole just gain some space. placed right. It's because the other one was placed perfectly. The last effort for the rest. So I have the cards again. Don't know about gray, maybe go black. Victor Mac. Can't mess with gray. I don't know. Still got the red. That's dominant. Put that inside. Snap. Maybe use a smaller. Equally wide, 28. Now covering up three different gaps there, which means it was a high difference now. It's pretty big. Thank you. the curbs on the outside open here, because it's outside. Come outside here. Into the street. See if I can use the panel on the other side. Moved it up a bit, and I can use the so I'll lower this under the pit wrap. Connects to this one, I can glide it out more over here. So that gave me the option to cover the curb here and not override this bit here. It which is only about 5 kids top, not even for the last 10 version. Right. You can do a pit stop there with GTA mode pit stop. Might pop this. Angle it a bit like this to get underneath the track, drops on the other side corner here. There's gonna be a wall here anyway. Okay, so took care of a lot of ground. Going back to some angled props. Always good to switch between sections in your process so you don't stare dead on one stone or one section. Might look at this here. Place this in the same position here. I want some extra curve on the outside, so I might put it here. Maybe further even. I connect this to the other one? Get the other curve, and it goes below here. Nice. So now I just move it over. Got a good privilege now. Come here, go here, outside, red, danger zone. Right. Get that up here. Thank you. see. How easy it is to get rid of the curves if you don't use try to speed it up.